cryptos don't fall. What? You wanna know about the last information of the fiascos in the crypto space? Yes, then smash that like button, cause it's time for crypto news fun on the right, crypto a tope. We still have bad news, we have some good ones too, but first of all, let's take advantage of Black Friday. We have good news about our favorite cold wallet, Ledger Nano S Plus or X, and this is the first time you listen about it, and it's that they have a special promotion, special offer, and you're gonna have $30 in Bitcoin or $20 in Bitcoin if you buy Ledger Nano X or S Plus. How you have to do that? Use the link in the description to buy the device, and afterwards you have to learn, and you can do that on fanontheright.com, about the app Ledger Live, and use that in your cell phone so you can claim your coins. Here in this tutorial, I explain you everything about it. Link is in the description below. More about Black Friday. Remember Amazon, if you don't use Amazon Prime, just start using it because you have up to 45% discount in Amazon. It doesn't matter what you buy there. You're going to have special offers and you are helping us indirectly. Thank you very much. Also, if you want to give a song as a present to someone that's special for you, you have a 20% discount with canciona.com, fan on the right, 20 is the code you have to use. And let's jump into the crypto space and the fiascos. We are in extreme fear, we are in the 21 right now, and the Simpsons telling us that FTX was the biggest scam in history, but Homer reminds us, yes, is the biggest scam so far. We'll see about that, just as when they tell us we are 70% down in our portfolio with coin tracking, but we say, yes, we are 70% down so far. The most fear in the market right now is this Joe Biden leading critical call for game-changing global and crypto rules after shock of FTX collapse. But I believe that's hypocrisy. Why? Because allegedly there are some people investigating, and all people related with FTX has connections with the government in United States. Remember that cryptocurrency CEO donated second largest amount to Joe Biden campaign. And we have this amazing video about Chico Crypto. Just watch that, and also you practice your English with that. And he's linking Sam and his girlfriend, the CEO, ex-former CEO of FTX, with very important people in the world of the economics, university, and government in United States. So he is telling us at the end of the video that maybe it's possible that Sam was used by the government in order to go into crypto, take all the money, steal all the money possible in order to do those donations, learn everything about the crypto world, and then give the tools for the government in order to regulate and centralize the crypto space for good. We'll see about that. It's not just the president of United States saying bad things about the crypto world. Also, the Fed president is saying that the entire notion of crypto is a nonsense following this controversial implosion of FTX. So not just Bitcoin, not Ethereum, just the whole thing is a huge scam. That's what he's telling us. We believe they are trying to fat us. Fear, uncertainty, doubt. They want us to sell all our cryptos. I believe that. We'll see about it. More bad things. The hack of FTX. We can see now how the hacker is selling those coins and how this is affecting Ethereum. Anytime the hacker sells those coins, you can see that Ethereum is going down to the $1,000 range, and probably is due to this hacker selling coins. Allegedly, the government of Bahamas could be behind the hack. That's what this article and some people are telling us. The government of Bahamas ordered SBF hack FTX. Is that even possible? Is the government of Bahamas one of the most biggest huge whales in the crypto space with the Ethereum they hold? More than that, this guy with the government behind it or not, allegedly is converting millions in REN tokens. This is a token linked related to Alameda. So again, we can see how everything is connected in what seems to be a huge scam. Lark Davis is telling us also very important news for this week. If Genesis, if Grayscale, if they are gonna have that $1 billion they need in order to remain with liquidity. And Dr. Profit telling us that if not, just picture what's gonna happen. With Luna Fiasco in summertime, they got 80,000 Bitcoin. And we knew what happened. Well, Grayscale has 640 Bitcoin. So just imagine if they sell off that Bitcoin. Grayscale, that is telling us that they don't want to share proof of reserves, citing security concerns. Nobody believes that. Anyways, they're saying that the funds remain safe and secure. What do you think about that? And Vitalik Buterin is telling us that all this fiasco is going to be useful so that in the future, all centralized entities will have some relation with that decentralized entity. It will be crypto related. Maybe all of them will use Chainlink, or maybe his solution, he bets on CK Snarks, for example, for that proof of reserves. More fiascos. Now it's BitBuy, the exchange that allegedly is not allowing withdrawals. Also the same for CoinFile EX, allegedly. And if you were affected by the fiasco of Celsius, now we have a deadline for Celsius customers to file claims in the bankruptcy case. That would be January the 3rd. But be careful with that. You have to do your own investigation about this. It took me 15 minutes this morning to find this video, but go beyond that. If you are affected, take a lot of time researching for good sources, etc. But this guy is telling us that, yes, there's that thing that you have to fill. He explains you how to fill it, but then he doesn't recommend you do it. Why? Because they are forcing you to set a value of your cryptocurrencies in dollars. And right now we are in crypto winter. So you would be recognizing a huge loss. What we want is to have our Bitcoin or Ethereum back if you were affected. Luckily, this is not my case for this one. So again, watch the whole video and go beyond this video, investigate a lot, talk with experts, and then decide if you want to fill this or not, and try to find information about what to do. Bitcoin, with all those fiascos, is going down, and right now we're getting close to the minimum of the past month, 15,500. If we broke that line, well, maybe $9,000 is in the cards. As Magic Pump Canoon is telling us, with the same chart I'm using and with the same colors for the blue line and the yellow one, for me it's crazy. It's like, are you watching my channel, Magic Pump Canoon? Hopefully so. Now, with that flag, he's telling us that we might drop close to 40%. We will go to that $10,000 range. We'll see about that. And if you want to be an expert like Magic Pump Canoon, or do that kind of things that I do here, not being an expert, you have a special offer. It's a Black Friday promotion too, so it's gonna run fast. You have just 4 days for having up to 60% off in your Pro Plus or Premium subscription for TradingView. That's the program I use, the site I use. Also, you're gonna have 1 month for free, not 12 months, but 13. So good. And if you don't want to pay, well, remember that you have Atani, our friends and partners. You have the link in the description. It's a free app and you can do some of the things you can do with TradingView Pro, but without having to pay. So you can start here with Atani, and if that's not enough for you, like myself, for example, I'm premium, well, then you go to TradingView Pro and take advantage of the discount. Back to the charts. Here is the 1 week for dollar versus Bitcoin, and you can see that starting March 2022, dollar started going up and Bitcoin down. So we need a reversal on this trend. Also, gold going up today. We'll see about Bitcoin and the stock market. For how long can the stock market bear market be here? Well, the average is 19 months. We are so far 10 months in the bear market. So 9 more months to go. But on the top of it, in 1937, it was 62 months. So maybe we need a lot of patience right now. Give me some optimism, Rodri, please. Well, here you have the halving narrative that says that we are close to the bottom if we are following the same path of past halving cycles. We are 30 months after the halving, and the last time we bottomed, it was 29 months. And in 2015, it was 26 months. So we are 30 months already. So it's more than 29. So it would be the longest period until it recovers. So maybe just tomorrow it will start going up. But maybe if we follow this path, we have to wait till 2025-26 in order to have a new all-time high. And maybe next whole year is going to be a disaster for the crypto community. More good charts. For example, this one related with MVRVZ. Anytime we are here down in the white section, we start going up like here and here and here. So maybe this is another good thing. And as Peter Brand is telling us, when everybody believes that it's the end, is when the thing recovers. So the Economist is dedicating the cover to the crypto's downfall. And also Bloomberg says the crypto world is in ruins. So maybe now is the moment where there's blood in the streets, as Warren Buffett told us, the moment to be greedy when everybody is scared. And we have our optimistic chart that we watch every single crypto news because we want this to happen. We pray at least for one more crypto bull. And we promise to the gods of crypto that this time we will start taking profit when we are in the past all-time high. So come on, just one more time, please. And we are not the only believers on the crypto space. Josh Rager is too. He's buying like he bought when Bitcoin was close to $30,000 in the last crisis in 2018. He bought at $3,300, but he had orders in $1,800. So right now it's the same. He's buying at $16,000, but he has some orders at 11, 13 rates. I will tell him, put some ones in 9,002. The market is in the red. The bubbles, don't touch my bubbles, are in the red too. And the most important cryptocurrencies are in the red. But we have good news for Michael Saylor and Litecoin. He believes that Litecoin is a commodity and sometime soon they will tell us it is so. And so Litecoin will go up again. Michael Saylor, that Dr. Profit is telling us that there's a lot of misunderstanding about the liquidation level of Michael Saylor. Bitcoin needs to hit 3,500 to liquidate only 4,500 out of his 130,000 Bitcoin total. So that's good for him. Good to know. And good news for Energy Web Token. Maybe we'll have our money back sometime in the future. We'll see about that. Chico Crypto is telling us about a partnership with Shell and about sustainable aviation fuel and how that cryptocurrency might be the chosen one for that solution. Hopefully that's true. Good news for Cardano. It's going to have its first stable coin and also a new blockchain and privacy token. Well, remember that. The regulators doesn't like that much privacy coins. The market in the DeFi ecosystem, Metaverse, NFTs, we are down for good on the 40 billion line. And the good news is that we have soccer. It's already on and over the reality asking us who owns those lands for the games and what are they gonna use there in those lands. They can use things like this. This is so sophisticated already, and we are just in day one. So what's going to happen in the future with OVR and the augmented reality? We can't wait for it. And more good news about ATMs in the world related to Bitcoin. We are closing the world to 4,000 ATMs all over the world. Here in Spain and Europe, the king is bitbase.es if you want to buy crypto online. But they have shops, they have ATMs all over the world. And if you want to have in your own business an ATM, just contact them, because they are in promotion for that right now. Let's go to our section of animals. We have a bear here, but it doesn't annoy us a lot, not even a little, because we are so used to danger. But maybe we are not so used to a shark being so close to us. What do you think? Is this safe? I don't think so. This cat is so confused with everything happening in the crypto space. He says this is all so kaleidoscopic and crazy. This rabbit that wants just to hide till winter is over, as this cat that only goes out for a little treat and then comes back. This cat just broken, is trying to drink more crypto, but not doing it properly. Also, this one broken too, see the legs? And he was biking in the crypto bull, but then he fell a little bit. And this one just so broken too. Right now works in the crypto winter while taking off snow from the roads. This one thought everything was under control, but then the control hit him for good. And what we have to learn about this is that when things come to a crypto winter, we find a slide and we just survive it and wait for the summer with a good attitude and sense of humor. If you want to learn all about this in Spanish and learning and improving Spanish at the same time, go to Fun and Drive, our primary channel in YouTube, where you have this very exact same content in Spanish. If you want more in English, just wait for more here in Fun and Drive. Health, money, love, party in peace, crypto a tope, and the best is yet to come.